It's been more than a year since a high school football game has been played in Oregon. And once football started up this week, players weren't sure what they were practicing for.
It was definitely starting to weigh on a lot of us, kind of the fact that maybe we're not going to have a season. Maybe this is all just kind of practice. There's really nothing leading up to it.
The fall season was pushed back until this month because of the pandemic. Wednesday's announcement has coaches like Lake Oswego's Steve Corey excited.
I think she's absolutely right that now we've got some responsibility as coaches, players, parents, whatever, to do everything we can to keep the mask on, the distance, and do all the protocols to keep this thing safe.
While the state will allow outdoor contact sports to continue, the OSAA says that schools in the counties that are lower at moderate risk can begin as soon as Monday. But the state says that schools in the extreme and high-risk counties must meet certain protocols. Schools that opt in for contact sports must have on-site testing for those showing symptoms and close contacts. They must have contact tracing and a waiver identifying health and safety risks related to COVID-19, as well as a commitment to isolation and quarantine if someone is exposed to the virus. OSAA's executive director Peter Weber says he's waiting for guidance to be finalized by the Oregon Health Authority before knowing how soon those schools in the extreme and high-risk counties can start.
Hopefully in these high and extreme, we can figure out the details on those pieces that are out there and get them going just as soon as possible too, hopefully by Monday if we can.
Westland senior Clay Masters is happy he finally has something to play for.
It's a big sigh of relief, honestly. It's something we've been pushing for so long to get the official go-ahead, and now it's finally here. I really could be happier.
Smaller colleges at the D2, D3, and NAIA level can also start outdoor contact sports as well. They just need to meet the same protocols as those on the D1 level and submit a health and safety plan. I'm Devin Haskins, KGW News.